What's up everyone? So in this video, we're going back to the biotech sector to share with you insights on a small penny stock which is developing some novel gene therapy to disrupt a disease which hits very close to home. And that's cancer and diabetes. And whilst there are many catalysts at play here, one of the major ones is that the US FDA launched an initiative that aims to expedite the development of gene therapies for patients with rare diseases. And as such, the FDA announced that it will support using biomarkers as substitutes for other biological indicators in gene therapy clinical trials, accelerating the approval process for companies. And what this really means is that this is a very positive development for this penny stock, as the FDA streamlines the regulatory process to help bring much needed therapies to patients more efficiently. And this decision by the FDA also underscores the potential role of gene therapy to provide long-lasting and even curative treatments for diseases that are currently difficult to manage or are untreatable. So make sure you stick around to find out from their CEO himself on why this opportunity could be one for your watch list. But before we jump in, here's what you need to know about the gene therapy sector before we jump into the detail of the stock. The global gene therapy market was valued at $2.9 billion in 2021 and is expected to reach over $15.6 billion by 2030, and that's a compounded growth rate of about 20.2% from 2022 to 2030. And gene therapy here is described as the treatment of an illness by changing, replacing or supplementing a missing or defective genetic combination that is responsible for the disease. And gene therapy has become one of the most desirable research goals in the fight against degenerative illnesses. And the need for gene therapy has been driven by an increase in the number of cases of cancer and other chronic illnesses across the world. And they are designed to treat diseases by altering genetic information, such as inactivating malfunctioning genes or replacing the disease-causing gene with a healthy copy of the gene. And this form of treatment could have the potential to cure diseases such as diabetes, cancer, heart diseases and AIDS, which is going to be game-changing. So make sure you stick around to find out whether this gem deserves a place on your watchlist or not, as I'm sure you would want to pay attention to its story. And so with that out of the way, please drop a quick like on the video and hit the bell so we can get talking about Genprex Inc, ticker number GNPX, which is now sitting at 86 cents per share with a market cap of $44.7 million. And Genprex has had a good last month in the markets, bouncing from its lows of 76 cents per share and now sitting up 13% in the last month. But on a year-to-date basis, it is still down 45%, which is a tough position to be in. But yet again, when you think about the current market environment we're operating, which has got high inflation, increasing interest rates, and many macro factors impacting the stock markets, then I feel it would be naive to write off stocks like this, which have life-changing potential without scratching the surface of them. And this is because when you just dig a little deeper, you begin to realize what an opportunity could be unearthed with this gem when you connect their management focus and their long-term plans. So as we always aim to buy low and sell high, these rock-bottom prices are presenting decent entry points for those who believe in their story, some excellent entry points for those with high-risk appetites to maximize the upside opportunity from this gem. So here's the latest on Genprex, which you need to be aware of. Genprex is a clinical stage gene therapy company focused on developing life-changing therapies for patients with cancer and diabetes. And Genprex's technologies are designed to administer disease-fighting genes to provide new therapies for large patient populations with cancer and diabetes who currently have limited treatment options. And they work with world-class institutions and collaborators to develop drug candidates to further their pipeline of gene therapies in order to provide novel treatment approaches. And their oncology program utilizes its proprietary non-viral Oncoprex nanoparticle delivery system, which the company believes is the first systemic gene therapy delivery platform used for cancer in humans. And the company's lead product candidate, REQORSA, is being evaluated as a treatment for non-small cell lung cancer, which is receiving a Fast Track Designation from the FDA, which you can see here, which is just a huge boost for them and their R&D pipeline timing. But before we go any further, let's hear from their CEO and chairman, Rodney Varna, to help bring to life what the company does, their portfolio, and what investors can look out in the months ahead from them.
So let's dive in. Now tell us more about Genprex and how it's been specializing in being able to administer disease-fighting genes to be able to help diabetic and cancer patients.
Well, Genprex is a gene therapy company developing therapies for both cancer and diabetes. For our cancer program, we use our proprietary Oncoprex lipid nanoparticle delivery system to deliver tumor suppressor genes to cancer. Our initial target is lung cancer, which is a very large market in excess of $20 billion a year, with many patients in need. The other market, the other gene therapy portfolio that we have, it's a totally separate portfolio in diabetes, and it's able to target both type 1 and type 2 diabetes.
And Rodney, how has the company been expanding its research in these therapies and also expanding its gene portfolio?
Well, we are conducting two clinical trials in our oncology program right now, and we'll be adding an additional one very soon. We have FDA Fast Track designations for the two ongoing trials. The trials are in non-small cell lung cancer and small cell lung cancer, which together make up about 100% of all lung cancers. We're moving those programs forward both through the clinical trials and through extensive preclinical research that continues at our academic partners. In the diabetes program, we're funding preclinical research there, which includes a recent study published at a prominent international conference showing that our gene therapy in diabetes had the ability to reduce the needs for insulin in non-human primates for statistically significant periods of time. So that's evidence of efficacy in non-human primates, which is a really big thing. So preclinical research in the cancer and diabetes programs, and clinical research in the oncology program are all ongoing and continue to be very promising.
And from there, what can we expect to see from the company in the coming quarters?
We expect to be announcing the completion of the phase one portion of our Acclaim 1 clinical trial. I anticipate that we'll be moving into phase two in that trial in all likelihood. And we'll be announcing opening of the Acclaim 3 clinical trial in small cell lung cancer, as well as other interim announcements from these trials. I also expect additional exciting research from the University of Pittsburgh from our diabetes program.
Wow, some really good prospects out there. Genprex also received a safety review committee approval to advance their phase 2 expansion portion of Acclaim 1 clinical trial of REQORSA in combination with Tagrisso in advanced non-small cell lung cancer. And the combination of REQORSA and Tagrisso received the FDA's Fast Track designation for treatment of the Acclaim 1 patient population. And Genprex also recently published positive clinical data from phase 1 portion of the Acclaim 1 clinical trial for their lead product REQORSA. And they said they were encouraged by the favorable safety profile of REQORSA, as well as the preliminary efficacy data observed, and they believe that this data will support the advancement to the phase 2 portion of the clinical trial. And analysts are seeking alpha say Genprex gene therapy has a potential breakthrough for diabetes and lung cancer. And they said the company's diabetes gene therapy exhibited encouraging results, improving glucose tolerance and reducing insulin requirements. And the GPX0203 gene therapy could be a long-lasting solution for diabetes, potentially benefiting many patients who require insulin replacement therapy. And their lead candidate REQORSA has received the FDA's Fast Track designation as a combination with Tagrisso. And they also had a strong financial position with zero debt and a cash balance of $29.5 million as of September 2022. And Robert Leboye, a senior equity research analyst with over 16 years of industry experience on biotech and pharmaceuticals, joined Noble Capital Markets in 2021. He reiterated a $5 price target on Genprex after the company announced their Phase 1 and 2 acclaimed trial in non-small cell lung cancer, giving an indication of how bullish they are on the prospects of this stock. And so from their current price levels, that's a staggering 5.8x from current levels, which is just massive. So some very, very interesting insights worth considering here with Genprex, but only consider getting in if the price is right for you and if you fully understand the risks. This video is not financial advice, a buy or sell recommendation, but it's meant to bring some new and exciting biotech stocks to your attention for you to do your own research. And as always, I would love to hear from you. So please let me know your thoughts on these top biotech stocks in the comment sections below and what other biotech stocks are catching your eyes lately. And if you're new to my channel, please ensure to subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified when I upload new videos. And if you would like to see more videos like this, please check out this video right here or this playlist right here to watch equally insightful content from the channel. Thank you so much for being here, and I look forward to having you in my next video. Thank you.